Hello, so this is exactly like a way monster. By the way, my total bullets looks like it's a funny number, so let's change that. Oh, that's pretty brutal, to be honest. Sorry about that, bird, but you're threatening me while I was telling a story by the fireplace. So it's exactly like in SpongeBob SquarePants, the French voice is like 5 hours later. I basically, you know, in the last episode went through the ghost pass and cleared it up, got a lot of loot, you know. We also unlocked the shortcut so we can go there anytime. So I basically went to the Cabal of the Wind Tower and I sold everything I had. Also got the ornate chest that is in the cellar. Remember, the corrupted tombs are over here, and over here there's a cellar that has two ghosts. You kill them, you pull a lever, and there's an ornate chest. And actually, I got all of the skills from the Cabal of the Wind. I had to come back over here, collect some more silver, then go back, and it was a nightmare, a logistical nightmare. I got a lot of silver from there, but I also came back and got all of the silver I had in my bag. So I'm almost broke right now. I think I have more money because I collected all of the fishes from the other stuff. Anyway, it was annoying. It was very annoying and I had to do a lot of stuff. So the Cabal Hermit, even now, is the best skill in the game. So after 2 DLC, they couldn't find something more appropriate to... I don't know. I'm just a little disappointed. So the Cabal Hermit still has the best skills for you to take. No matter what your build, always take these skills. Because even though the reveal soul and call to elements and mana push and other stuff is not so useful, the shamanic resonance where a boon is increased, it's amazing. Plus the infuse the wind and sometimes even the conjure. So I got all of the stuff. I could afford all of the stuff. Also, I killed the Wendigo. The Wendigo is not so hard to kill, but there was a nice elemental in there. And also the little horror guys that spit fire. So they started fighting each other, the element with the horror things. And everyone was fighting everyone. It was chaos. And I was fighting the Wendigo a little bit, but with my pistol... Oh yeah, I definitely forgot about this combination. So the pistol, the obsidian pistol, and the wind sigil is still such a great combo. I cannot believe how strong it is even now in the game. Because this is not based on the damage, it's based on attack speed and impact. So let's go do a quick recap of what you get for getting the Cabal Hermit skills. I love them so much. Call to element, which maybe it's not so useful. I mean, it depends where you are. Frost damage and resistance, amplified hot weather defense. The conjure, if we find the soul, reveal soul and conjure can summon a ghost friend. Infuse wind for 3 minutes. Stamina bonus faster, doesn't really matter, it's amazing. Mana push is not so good, the other stuff is not so good. Also the weather. The weather tolerance is pretty good as well. So from now on we'll be using a lot of potions, like I said. Also crafted a golem elixir and the stone flesh elixir, just so I'm super careful and a little more confident that I can kill the last thing, the last warlord. Actually, I need to do something like this, assign to the quick slot. I don't know, it seems like I will not need to use the shield for a very long time. Also, I'm carrying a lot of junk with me. I don't know what I can throw away, because to me everything seems important over here. Well, I guess I don't need as many potions and varnishes and stuff. We will see. So I killed the Wendigo. The loot on the Wendigo was pretty good. There was a destroyed tent in the Wendigo's cave, which also had a lot of loot. So that's why I could afford all of this. Also, remember, in the other adventures, we found another power coil. So we can solve the Sierzo power coil problem. From which I drank the water. Yeah, it was a nice story time. I mean, I could have recorded another 40-minute episode or longer. But to be honest, it was a lot of legwork and we just killed the Wendigo and not much else. So I decided to not record that portion because, yeah, it's kind of boring anyway. Yeah, I almost died a lot of times. I had to sleep a little bit. No, don't drink it again.
What? This worry. Can you lend me a hand? Oh, thanks a bunch.
Ooh. I can finally drink clean water, fresh, cool water. Empty that. Empty both of them. Okay, so now we have fresh cool water. for the first adventurer. Now I also have the Koi Lantern, which has a lot of fuel, but I'm a little worried because... We have to find more. We have to find a battery before I start using it seriously. Okay, so now we'll go to Vendaval Fortress, get the reward for killing the Wendigo, and kill the other warlord. Yeah, I don't know. Like I said, it's a lot of legwork.
Greetings, friend.
And to be honest, the rewards are not so good, but I just prefer it to do the right way. So I'm showing you kind of like the preparation phases because I use a lot of potions and a lot of food. If you don't use them right now, you'll have a lot of problems surviving in the game or... Depending on the spiritual varnish I can put over there. The best type of damage is usually the fire axe because it's damage over time, I don't know. I use it a lot. I don't need a linen cloth, I have so many bandages already. Also, I have some ocean fricassee, I cooked some fresh for our adventure because we need some mana regeneration for the wind sigil because we will use it a lot. Let's put that in there. I'm afraid of my lantern going out and I'll be left in the darkness. Do I need this armor? No, because I have this one. I'm wearing this for the cold weather defense mostly. Let's put that in here because I'll not be using it probably. Also the shield. No. I'm not using the shield because now we have a lot of stamina and we can actually have some stamina regeneration as well because of the food and the other stuff. So we can kind of leave the shield alone. I have a little more money. Yeah, money is kind of easy to make right now in the game because of all the fishing and all of the caches you can loot and all of the stuff I looted from there. I think I had about 7 or 8 ghost eyes. Endurance potion. I don't think I'll... Why am I getting 7 of them? The max I'll need all the time will be 2. I also don't need that one. Cause damage and resistance. And I guess we can use some of these potions I've been keeping on myself. Oh, I need to use a worm potion? Yeah, I think I should have been using a worm potion all the time and I kept forgetting. So yeah, the worm... Now this is amplified, I'm not sure. So I think it will be what? What's the normal defense when you're not using the amplified version? I think it will be 10 or something like that. I don't know, but I definitely forgot to use the stupid potions, the stupid worm potions. So let's use the stupid worm potions from now on. When did I drink water? Oh, I crafted the potions. So now we're basically ready to go to Vendaval and show them who's boss. They are the boss, of course, but I will show them. Yeah, I'm happy about my current progress in the game. I mean, it was basically about 20 hours of game time. I don't know, it was crazy how much I played this in this version. Mainly because I had forgotten a lot of things and I had to search a lot of wikis and I had to... I also died a few times in the beginning. But this time, this is the playthrough where I'll finish everything and also... I'm a bit afraid about going to Harmattan and the Teak Plateau and doing stuff over there since I'm pretty sure we're not ready for it. So yeah, we'll just have to see. I mean, we'll probably have a few episodes where we just run around and collect junk. I mean, we can be a garbage collector. Okay, let's play a little more. Don't move. Don't become a zombie. So yeah, again, most of the episodes are me explaining stuff because in the game, if you want to do a Let's Play Valtort, you'll need so many edits and so many cuts. It's not feasible. It's not going to work. So that's why I prefer this format where I basically compress 5 hours of a game time in 5 minutes by just explaining and showing. I don't think everyone likes this, but what can I do? Sure. I guess we can eat some of this. No, we'll not eat anything. Also, one of the things I wanted to test out is the auto walking. So if you... That's hilarious. That's the best way to hunt the annoying birds. Now, I really don't need all of this, but I'll take this time. I'll take it this time. I guess I can make some jerky with all of the meat, but still, it's a lot of work. I'm not willing to put up with. Okay, so I'll just use auto walking for a moment. And let's enjoy the scenery. And that, there goes the enjoyment of the scenery. You want to see how this will be? I didn't even need to use it, but I just like it. Okay, let's collect that as well. Yeah, those are a lot of hyenas. I mean, now it's worth it to kill the hyenas for their bones and the other stuff. I probably should keep the bones for the bone broth. I think the bone broth gives you something really nice. Well, now we have to eat the ocean fricassee. The ocean fricassee is the best food for an overall balanced stuff. So you get health regenerate, health recovery level 2, stamina level 3, and mana level 2. Kind of like the most balanced food out of all of them in the game. Later on we have to make the... I forgot the names of them, but you know, it's the thing that you put pearl bird meat with. I think the caches restored their... No. They restored them. How long was I gone? Okay. So I guess they restored their loot every 7 days or something like that. I don't know. I mean, when I was playing on my own, I was basically running all the time. And yeah, that's the whole point of the potions. You do a lot of background work. This is the same way I played out already in the beginning. I do a lot of background work and then I come back over here and I show you what I did. Or most of the things I did. Such a cool glow to it, adds such a cool effect. So basically now it doesn't really matter that much what weapon I have, as long as I have ammunition in my pistol and the buff on my sword or my weapon. Also, I wanted to get everything, or more or less everything, the normal way. I think I missed the preservation backpack in my first playthrough because I kind of killed her or something. Yeah, it's a fun game. I cannot complain about many things, to be honest, but I'll only say that the game had so much potential and they just ruined the potential by giving us things that didn't really matter that much, to be honest. I mean, look at this. This is all empty space. Nothing to attack you, nothing to interact with, nothing to see, nothing to do. Yeah, you may think, yeah, you can collect some loot and stuff like that, but there are many ways that are much better to collect the loot. Oh, I forgot to sleep before I left. Well, to be honest, I think I should sleep. Again, I'm just taking all of the precautionary matters. Precautionary... By the way, this is a skull icon, a skull... thingy on the ground. Yeah, let's sleep for 2 hours. It'll be okay. Yeah, if the developers would have put more effort into populating the world and actually making it more viable for co-op, because right now it's you can walk all over the map and collect all the loot and sell it, and then sleep for 3 days in a row in your bed and then go and collect it again. It's kind of like how much time do you want to waste? Okay, I also want to see the lantern in the darkness. Shining bright, and not like a diamond. Diamonds don't shine. Diamonds reflect light. Oh yeah, this is much better. Okay, these guys are still dead. No, yeah, it's good. It's good. Oh, there is another crab on the beach. Yeah, I think the developers should just give the game to modders at this point, because modders will... Ma... The modding community, this sounds better. The modding community will just give the game everything they wanted, and besides, it will incorporate all of your favorite mods, like having more quick bar slots, like having shared inventories between all of your houses. And also, one of the things I really, really want now is that the cities don't reset anymore. I don't care about the tiny amount of loot you can get in a city, I just want my camps to be left alone, my hobo camps, you know, with the alchemy sets, the fireplace, the cooking pots, the backpacks. Because that's a lot of time you spend sorting and organizing them. What did I drink? I was not supposed to drink that yet, probably. Anyway. So this is for defense, physical defense. Oh, I think this one kind of overrides it. So what did I... Oh, this is only for impact defense and this is for the rest. Also, a funny thing. You might not know this, but if you use the potion, what is that called? What is that skill called? Oh yeah, call to elements. In here you'll get the rage bonus. The rage buff, amplified weapon impact by 35%, which is a lot. Only in Vendaval, so outside you get the cool bonus, here you get this one. I guess you can still fight her if you want, but we don't want to kill anything, everything, we're not monsters.
You're not one of my warriors. You're from Sierzo. I can sense my late husband's mana clinging to your very skin.
Where'd he
Thanks.
go? She gives you a power coil as well. Okay, that fixes my lantern problem. So if you remember, the preservation backpack was the backpack that slows the decay of the food when it. Whatever. You understand what I'm saying. So it slows down the decay of the food in your backpack, but it's also a very great backpack to just have normally on you. Because it's 65 weight, 75 weight, and also no penalty. So it's a great. How should I put that? It's a great alternative to the Merfino backpack if you don't know about it or if you don't like it because it's ugly and big and looks weird. Yeah, it still slows you down. Oh, I have so many videos to make. I guess I can do the videos to all the backpacks and all the other stuff. Okay, I'll have to do that in the weekend or sooner. This weekend I'll be working, so I don't think I'll have time in the weekend. Also like the fact that I don't get angry when you pull out the sword. Dismissed. So that's two warlords. I only have one. Where is the last warlord? I forgot where he is. I hope he's not hard to find. I think we just need to go in the dungeon for that. I don't think the chest will restock. No, I don't think they'll restock, maybe. Oh, what did I take? Stop taking everything from the floor. Okay, so when you come over here, that's up. Okay, that's my, this is my only way. Well, bottoms up. It's so expensive to make those golem potions, but it's definitely worth it. So what do I get if I use this one right now? Oh yeah, you do get physical defense. Physical weapon. Oh, you get physical weapon impact resistance and physical weapon damage. Look at all of this stuff. Physical weapon damage. Plus you get the heavy, the rage plus the impact up. Okay, this is a lot of bonuses. So this is why I love the Cabal Hermit. So 55% extra impact. Physical damage will be increased by 50%. Plus if I activate the wind, that will be even more impact. Okay, now you don't want to fight me. Now remember, you can still sell the iron and some other stuff. You can still use these guys. You can use all of the facilities that are here, including selling iron and cooking and stuff. It's kind of interesting. I always thought you'd be the ruler of Endavel Fortress, but I don't know why the developers didn't go full in, full leave it closed. Full circle. They should have just went ahead and... Oh, that's nice. They should just have went ahead and said you are kind of like the ruler of Endavel if you want. Okay, so keep in mind, we need ammunition. Also, I guess we can need some of this as well, because they will overwrite the effects, so we'll probably have the best of all of the things. I don't think I'll need more than that. Yes. Okay, here it goes. I'm still afraid. Okay, let's enchant everything.
Who are you? And why do you dare? Aho! You care? You want me to call off the destruction of Cieza? If you agree, I will let you leave to bring him here.
Well, I guess you can bring it over here and that will be the quick solution to all of this, but no.
Someone's about to get it.
Not today.
Not happening.
And his little archers are over... Yeah, I remember. I'll not get peppered with arrows, you idiots. Oh, there are three archers. I thought there are only two. Okay, now let me show you what I mean. Shoot! Oh. He blocked it. Yeah, he cannot resist. Even though he's wearing heavy armor, the speed of which I can attack him and just put him to the to the wall, that's hilarious. This combination is hilarious. I need to do this a lot more, but again, this was a lot of preparation and a lot of planning. And then you just get his shield. Ouch, overweight. Hold on, I will drop this. So that's the Vendavel quest solved. Yeah, don't take the easy way out. I guess the developers wanted you to have a lot of ways to do this, but don't betray your friends, your masters, don't betray your mentor. So what's all of this? Crimson shield is mine, simple bow. Oh, he has a saber. Well, you tried. And that's all that matters. Even more jerky. Okay, that was very interesting. Sorry about all of the talking in the beginning, but... which was a little better, right? We just had a lot of action and we solved a lot of quests. And this is... I don't think this is anything. It just shows you where the ship is. And I always thought, why didn't they go further with this? Why can you not go on the ship, loot it, and fight some more people? I don't know. Maybe the developers didn't have time, but come on. I really wish you could have taken a boat and went over there to kill a boss or something. Like that. Or maybe you can, and I don't know it yet. I also think they should have given you an ornate chest over here. They give me a fish. Thank you for the trout. You killed the warlord. Here is a fish. Slapping me in the face with the fish you gained. Yeah, it didn't disappoint me, to be honest. I mean, look at all of the silly nonsense we had to do this so easy. Of course, this was only a one-time thing, because I'll not spend so many resources and so much time on only one boss fight. Not boss fight, only one fight. But from now on, we'll mostly use the things we have. I just need to get a better weapon, to be honest. And remember, the door locks behind you, so you cannot escape once the combat starts. Oh no, we have to fight the guards. I think. Iron claymore, well. They do have a lot of weapons, so this is their armory. Stability potion, poison. Added armor, so yeah, you do have a little bit of stuff over here. And this chest will have your items, so if you don't die, or if you don't end up in here, or if you don't open it. What did I press? No. That's the guy that killed me last time I tried this. It's relatively quiet, okay. So yeah, I basically defeated them with the power of money. A lot of money and a lot of patience and a lot of work. You can technically do the Vendavel things about 5 hours into the game, but that will be hard and you need to be super careful. I'm not careful. I don't want to wait that much, but... Okay, now let me give you a pro tip over here. If you really want to do mid-maxing and stupid stuff, or boring stuff, basically get all of their weapons and destroy them. You'll get iron scrap. Actually, let's do it right now. And I'll show you what you can do with that. The mace. I hope I don't destroy something important by accident. And even the shield is one scrap. That's nice. Well, I guess I have a lot of room. I could have taken everything. Now let's go and sell some of the scrap we got. There might be another... guard over here. I think that's the way up, okay. It's like I'm in the Matrix, dodge this. By the way, they're wearing heavy armor. So don't let your guard down. Especially these guys are dangerous. But then just take one hit with the... Oh wow, okay. Come on, how much can you defend? that's so much fun. It's a silly thing to do, but it's a lot of fun. But yeah, the game definitely has gotten harder, I'll tell you that, and it's gotten much harder. You know, I drink this potion just in case I forget someone. But again, with this armor you can do it very easy, but I think the AI is cheating. There's no way you can attack that fast normally. And there's no way you can block that much damage with my impact. I don't think I was ever in the prison. I'll not get that mushroom again. I don't want to min-max so much. Yeah, but we'll get the star mushroom. Again, win the game through the power of more money. More silver. It's so much better when I can see what's inside the cells.
Is there something you need?
Give me the shift dagger. You can also buy the gravel beetles. They're pretty important as well. I don't have enough silver. Here, buy some stuff for me so I'm not so poor. Oh, I don't think he gives us a lot of money. I don't think he buys stuff. Has a very limited... Well, what do you want to buy? Okay, buy some slippers, buy that. Now, normally the prisoner should escape, but because the developers didn't think you would do it like this... Oh, don't use bed. Okay. See, they could have added more stuff for Vendaval prison as well. Oh, green garb, that's nice. Two astral potions, that's very... The astral potions are one of the most expensive things you can sell. I think they are 8 silver. Okay, what button am I pressing? Are you the lady that wants to be free? No. Yeah, it's in poor taste. So the lady that buys your... Well, I guess you can get all of this because we need a lot of bullets. And this is how I get my bullets. By just mining the iron veins all over the place. I think you can also jump through the hole, but that would be dangerous at this point. So I guess if you enter it this way, you will not get the option to do the quests, or... Did I do them beforehand? No. So she will not buy your... Yeah, they fixed the exploit, so you cannot sell the iron...
Is there something you need?
You cannot sell the iron ore after you do this, the hard way. Which was an exploit that didn't need to be fixed, but the developer still did it. I guess it's understandable, but come on, who used this exploit except me and a few other people? Basically, you just destroy all of the weapons you get along your playthrough, and once you get here, you have about 100 iron scrap. So if you sell 100 scrap, that would have been 500 silver, but again, who uses that exploit except for a few people? A few select people, me included. Yeah, so we didn't need a shiv after all. Prison key and double key. I guess I'll just keep those as memories. So the quest, Sierzo. Most of them will attack on site now. Oh, we have to get back to Vendaval to see the reward. Okay, we'll go back to Vendaval and then I'll end the video. Because I want to see the reward as well. And that's the end of the saga of Vendaval. They were a very brave bunch of bandits, but in the end, they couldn't do anything about my sword. I don't know. With what weapon can you kill those guards? Because the boss fight might be hard, might be annoying, but you have a few options. Like I showed you, you can stun lock the boss. You can do some silly things as well. Where are my warm potions? Okay, here it is. You can do some silly things with the boss. I mean, that just sometimes will hit you, sometimes they'll not hit you. Wait, that's expensive. Ah, take everything. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's put on our traveling gear. What armor has a nice amount here? This should be good. It's overweight. Sure, I can. Okay. Let's not think too much about it. So yeah, because the weapons are kind of bad right now, with what weapon can you defeat a Vendavel Fortress Bandit? That's a good question, because I have abused the system a little bit with too much stamina, with too much resistances, with too much attack speed. But if you don't do it like this, with what can you kill them? So yeah, I guess all you're left with is the power of money. it was a nice adventure. So from now on, what can I do? Well, we still have a little bit of work over here with the Vigel Pylon. And I think then we have cleared the entire map. Except for the bandit camp, but... not the bandit camp, I cleared it off camera. Because I cleared it in my other Let's Play through that I quit because I was very weak. No, I think we cleared the entire map. I also did all of the Conflux Chambers. I didn't show them on camera because it was pretty boring and I already did one of them. Basically, you should do the Conflux Chambers after you do the bandits, the bandit camps, and kind of loot everything, the blue sand over there. Or maybe you can do them. No, I don't think you can do them before the bandit camps. You will be kind of weak anyway. Yeah, so that was kind of like my idea for the game right now. I think we're doing pretty well. We have a lot of money, and when we'll go to the next region. No, I don't care about those guys. They're very weak right now. It's not even worth killing them. So wherever the butterflies are, in theory, there should be a possible spawn for the Soroban Caravaner, but you don't find him that often. Wait, how much weight I have? Perfectly balanced, as all things should be. Yeah, because of my little detour in the animal car forest, I don't need anything from the merchant. I guess I can build some crazy stuff as well, but it's not worth it. Also, the developers could have fixed a lot of things, like this thing over here. Which annoys me every time I see it. Yeah, so cool game, cool quest, I don't know. Like I said, the developers should just give the game to the modding teams, and the modding teams might be able to, I don't know, at least give us a lot more enemies and a lot more challenges, more interesting crafting recipes. I don't think they should touch the weapon balance. The weapon balance is kind of okay right now because every weapon is bad. And that's kind of like the balance, everything is bad. I'm cold, even with all of this. Am I wearing my special hat? No, I'm not. I don't think the tea will warm us up. It doesn't matter if we get a cold or not. By the way, I'm a bit lost, but I'm also searching for more Soroban Caravan locations. Also, if you go up the mountain, sometimes you'll find some interesting loot. There is a greasy or oily ferg, what, I don't know what it's called, I forgot. But it's one of those greasy things. Okay, let's see what it's called. Greasy fern. which I need a lot of them to make the potions, the greater healing potions. Also, there is one of the bigger iron ores over here. So I like this area because it's actually pretty rich in resources. Oh, I got the tourmaline. So again, that's a lot of money you can just get from this place. I think I skipped over the crafting table, the new crafting table for the totems, but it doesn't matter. Now the question is that I keep forgetting how to get down. I think that we need a sled. There, safely went down the mountain path. Yeah, again, this is one of the things I don't think a lot of people know about with the greasy fern over there. So we have at least two spawns, or maybe there's only two spawns, one on top of the Conflux Mountain and one over there for greasy ferns. So most of the things you can craft in the game, I mean, don't just buy them, because the greater healing potions are quite expensive. Craft whatever you can, whenever you can. Also, I don't think I looted this place, because usually I forget to come over here, because either I'm chased by something or I don't care. And it's still a lot of good money. So, you know what I'll do? I think before I start the next episode, and then we'll go to the Ancient Plateau, maybe. No, I think I'll do it on camera. I'll do the pylon stuff on camera. Then we'll go back to Sierzo. But no, I think before I start recording for the game, I'll have to create a brand. I'll have to go to the desert and buy all of the stuff. So with all of the stuff I have right now, I'll sell all of it, and with the money I'll go to the desert and buy the things I need to craft the brand sword. And then we'll go to the pylon stuff and kill the golems and whatever is there, and then we'll go to the Antique Plateau. So that will be a lot of fun, because I never played the DLC area, so it will be a mystery and a surprise. One thing I don't like is that basically going to that area, it will kind of make useless all of the gear we can get from the other area. So the forest, the desert, and the swamp will basically be useless and will have useless gear for us. Maybe except for the leech.
Need
in the
something?
Swamp. Oh.
My thanks. This is for you.
Great life potion, Sierzo Town Key. Oh, you get a town key, so that's how you get it. Okay, I completely forgot about this. The town key should allow us to access the legacy chest, if I remember correctly. Okay, let's make sure that's how it works. Also, we're already in town, so we can drop some of this stuff over here and I'll pick it up later. I'm too lazy to sell it right now. Ah, we're also cold, doesn't matter, I will heal fast. There might be an ornate chest in the town hall, and in the fishing area or that cave over there, there is the legacy chest. If I remember correctly, that is. Oh, nice, another power call. So see, they did increase the rate at which they spawn. I've been getting so many power calls. Usually power calls was the rarest thing in the game beforehand, and I think I would have preferred it to be like that. You should have to go to another city to buy it, but now they're just all over the place. Two for the backpack, two for the fountain, one more for a reserve battery to charge the thingy. That's not so bad. So I'm curious, what kind of boon do you get if you use the skill over here? The Call of Elements. I guess you'll get a cold one again, yeah, the cold one. But they did lower the amount of loot you can get from the ornate chest. The ornate chest have super bad loot now. Was this worth it? No, not really. Horror bow. You know what, I think I'll learn it. Jerky. Yeah, let's learn some of the potions, because again, you can make a lot of money just by selling them, but no. Let's learn to use some of them. By the way, if you fall off this cliff over here, you can die and it can cost you 10 days of in-game time. Which is not so bad, but there will be a lot of time quests. Oh, I forgot about this. So in the Antique Plateau in Harmattan, did that move? It moves. Oh, that must look very special during the night time. Okay, we'll just leave it like that. Imagine if you have 5 of those backpacks with the rolling lanterns in them. It'll be like the disco. It'll be like a nightclub. Also, I think this area resetted, so I guess I can make my troglodyte play right now. Okay. Yeah, this is actually a very big step in the gameplay, because now you can create legacy characters and you can start a new game with, let's say, the Cerulean weapon or the meteoric pistol, or the meteoric obsidian pistol, which will give you such a big boost in your other game. It's almost like cheating. It's almost like really, really cheating. Well, see each other next time. Bye.